the as a candidate for ombudsman. Mm-hmm. So there will be names that will be submitted to the JBC. Mm-hmm. And from there, the JBC will interview all the prospective candidates and they will come up with a list, and that will be submitted to the president. Remember, there was a situation in the time of GMA where she didn't like the nominees for the Supreme Court justices.
Yes. Uh-huh.
And she returned to them, and the Supreme Court said, no, you have to follow the list.
So you really just have to stick with the short list that's produced by the JBC.
Yes.
I see. Sir, former Justice Artemio Toquero, his appointment to the JBC was not renewed. Does that have anything to do with the fact that he's with Iglesia Ni Cristo?
No. His being an Iglesia Ni Cristo is not a point against him. It wasn't a point against him. In fact, I was part of that. It wasn't even considered. It mm-hmm. wasn't because he was an Iglesia Ni Cristo. That's the reason why his appointment was not.
Why then? What was the reason then?
Well, the committee decided to they prefer someone who's a member of the. Jojo Mejia was supposed to be the representative for the IBP, but they decided to move him as a representative of the academe, mm-hmm. and then to choose someone else from among the IBP.
Okay, so no truth to that, because there's a word going around that his being a member of the INC had mm-hmm. something to do with it, because the ombudsman,
I can confirm that it has nothing to do. I was present in the discussion, deliberation of the members of the JBC.
Okay.
I'm surprised with that kind of...
Well, you know, I might as well ask you all the questions that are surfacing. All right, we have to take a short break. Strictly Politics, we'll be right back. Stay with us.